Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning. Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Holy Trinity. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will we may gain eternal salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say one Our Father and one Hail Mary. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. But when the kindness and generous love of God our Savior appeared, not because of any righteous deeds we had done, but because of his mercy, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O Holy Trinity, Triune God, our hearts are restless until they rest in you. Turn our wanderings into a pilgrimage, drawing us ever closer to you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, living and reigning as one God forever and ever. Please be seated for our first reading. A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and generous God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people, yet pardon our wickedness and sins and receive us as your own. This is the word of the Lord. Our response is glory and praise forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice, mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. This is the word of the Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. John. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this verse that I just read to you came to me again while I was mowing the lawn on Friday. Someone was driving by, and a song was on the radio that they were blasting. It came out a few years ago. It's called John Cougar, John Deere, John 316. Ironically, I was on a John Deere tractor that was donated by Tom for our parish. And this is a key verse in Scripture because it tells us, firstly, that there are at least two persons in the Trinity, the Father and the Son, and also that he was sent so that we could have eternal life, that our souls could spend eternity with him in heaven. As we celebrate the solemnity of the Holy Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we may tend to think that we have this completely understood. Yeah, three persons, one God, okay. But I don't know about you, but for me, if I've ever looked into this, the more I've thought about it, the more complicated and mysterious it gets. How does it all work? Where did it come from? Where did God come from? And that is what we call a mystery in the church. Not a mystery like Sherlock Holmes or anything like that, but a mystery that we, on this side of heaven, are incapable of fully grasping and understanding, although we have the nuts and bolts of it. Three persons, one God. And that's why we have faith. We take it on faith that this exists for our benefit and to bring us to eternal life. Now, even one of the great doctors of the church, St. Augustine, he pondered for years trying to understand the Trinity. And one day he was walking on the beach by the sea, and he encountered a child who had dug a hole, small hole in the beach, and was taking his bucket and taking the water and pouring it in the hole. He watched him for a minute or two and asked the child, "What are you doing?" He said, "I'm trying to empty the sea into this hole." St. Augustine said, "Well, that'll take an eternity, if not more." And he said to St. Augustine, "Well, that is precisely what you are doing. It will take an eternity." And he disappeared. Well, it turns out that child was the archangel Gabriel giving St. Augustine a message that no matter how hard he tried, he could not understand the Trinity. And so is the same for us. That we may not completely understand it, and that's okay, but we believe. We believe that God the Father sent his Son to save us and his Holy Spirit to be with us, to guide us, so that we can have the opportunity of eternal life if we so choose. So, my brothers and sisters, let us perhaps today, this week, take some time out and pray to each of the three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, so that we may know them a little bit better by praying to them individually, but also to receive their grace and maybe get a tiny bit more understanding of the Trinity by praying to each person individually so we understand the fullness of God just a tiny bit better. God loved the world, so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. The Lord be with you. Trusting that God hears and answers our prayers, we now approach him with all of our needs. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that she may ever more effectively proclaim Christ, who leads all to the Father in the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord. For leaders of nations, that they may listen to one another with respect and mutual understanding and be instruments of Christ's peace, we pray to the Lord. For all married couples and families, that they may be witnesses to and examples of the love of the Blessed Trinity, we pray to the Lord. For all the sick and their caregivers, especially those on our parish prayer list, that they may find strength and endurance in the love of Christ, we pray to the Lord. For all the intentions we hold deep in the silence of our hearts, and for whom this Mass is being offered, which is an appreciation for all PNCC clergy on this Clergy Appreciation Weekend, we pray to the Lord. For all of our deceased family and friends and those who will die today, that they may be welcomed into the joys of eternal life, we pray to the Lord. Gracious God, you will that all people share in your triune life. Hear these our prayers, both spoken and unspoken, that we may one day enjoy everlasting life with you. We ask all these things through your Son, Jesus Christ, in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, bread to offer, fruit of the vine, work of your hands, may it become the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. And water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Are you, Lord God, all creation, through your goodness, wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice we prepare for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your
Lord God, Trinity in unity, as we offer our gifts of self and substance, we ask you to make them holy. Grant us an understanding of your inner life, for to that living mystery we have been called. We ask this through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what we believe of your glory through your revelation, we also believe of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, without difference or distinction. In confessing the true and eternal Godhead, we adore the distinction of persons, oneness in being, and equality in majesty. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. The Holy Sacrifice of the Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 2, which is found on page 82. And yes, you can resume kneeling since the Easter season has ended. We give thanks to you, God our Father, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, whom in these last days you have sent us as Savior, Redeemer, and Messenger of your will. He is your Word, inseparable from you. Through him you have made all things, and in him you are well pleased. You sent him from heaven to a virgin's womb. There he dwelt and was made flesh. He was revealed as your Son, born through the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin. When he suffered, he fulfilled your will and gained for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands to free from suffering those who believed in you. When he was betrayed to his freely chosen suffering, thereby to destroy death, to break the chains of darkness, to crush hell beneath his feet, to give light to the just, to make a covenant and to manifest his resurrection, he took bread. He gave you thanks and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you." In like manner, he took the cup and said, "This is my blood, which is poured out for you. Whenever you do this, do it in memory of me." Together, calling then his death and resurrection to mind, we offer you the bread and the cup. We thank you for allowing us to come before you and to serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your holy church to gather all in unity. Grant to all who partake of these holy mysteries the fullness of the Holy Spirit for the strengthening of their faith in the truth. So may we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him may glory and honor be yours, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, now and forever and ever.
On page 95, let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Yes, there is one bread. We are many in one body, for we all
may the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Please join me now in the Second Communion prayer found on page 98. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for my judgment or condemnation, though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament. Through your loving kindness, may it become my safeguard and healing remedy. My saving master, awaken in me a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make me your willing servant, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite me entirely with you, my Lord and my God. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. In the body of Christ, bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online or who for personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
Will you take what we have, a sacrifice unto you, then create clean hearts, and Lord, make our spirits new. Father, blessed Father, lead and guide us for your name's sake, and keep us in the shelter of your presence till we see your face. Let us hear you say, let us know your voice and all of your ways. Take our hands, lead us home to the refuge that we find in you.
Father, bless us, Father, lead and guide us for your.
Grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Let us pray. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, and source of the Spirit, you are the creator of all that exists, and the originator of all that is good. You loved us in Christ even before the world was formed. Grant through this holy Eucharist that our whole lives may only be a return to you from our first beginning through baptism in your holy name to our final goal. We ask this through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, through peace and battle, be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Is darkness light, and where there is sadness joy. O divine master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love, for it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for Holy Mass today. Pray that you can join us next Sunday, Saturday or Sunday at 5 p.m. Saturday or 9 a.m. Sunday, and during the week from Monday through Thursday at 9 a.m. And this Thursday will be the Solemnity of Corpus Christi, so we will have Mass at 9 a.m. and 6 p.m. So I hope you have a wonderful day, a wonderful weekend. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Remain in a state of grace. Fight evil wherever you find it. And more importantly, spread joy wherever you go.